I absolutely hate change. It's the only thing in life that I despise. The older I get, the less I like it. But at the same time, I've experienced it so many times in my life that I understand it probably better than a lot of people. As God grows us, it better changes. And there's something taking place tonight that some of you may not even know about, but it's very, very much in the forefront of our minds. And what is taking place is our tenor is singing his last concert with us. Now, he'll be here in the morning in the church service, and we'll sing a little bit in the morning, but this is his last concert with us. And he and his wife, Lauren, in fact, Lauren, if Lauren's close by, I want her to come up here right quick, like. Will you do that for me, sweetheart? These two are going back to Ohio this coming week, and I have asked the Lord to give me the right words to say during this moment, and I pray that he has given me the proper words from my heart, not to impress you, but to let you know how I feel about these two people. 45 years, August 17th, I'll celebrate 45 years of singing gospel music. And all of those years, I've never been around two people that I enjoyed being a part of their lives any more than I have these two right here. Two of the finest people I've ever known. And when Blake called me, and I'll never forget that conversation that day. He wanted to come down and try out. And I asked him the normal questions I always ask anybody that wants to be a part of our ministry. What's your name? He told me. So where are you from? He said, I'm from Stowe, Ohio. And I didn't hear anything else after he had said Stowe, Ohio, because I lived there for almost 11 years. And I knew about everybody there by the time I left. And I thought, if he can't sing, he's a good boy. I want him. But when he got here, he could sing. Not only could he sing, he had just gotten married, literally. They got married, went on their honeymoon, came home, packed, and moved. Poor Lauren, I've told folks for 4 years now, but Lauren did not know that she was marrying a gospel singer that's going to live in Alabama. She thought she married a construction worker that was going to live in Northeast Ohio. That was a shock, wasn't it, baby? Yeah. But she shouldered that responsibility like nobody that I've seen in many years past. And while it grieves us, it also thrills me that he took his time, prayed about it, they both did, and sought the Lord as to what they would need to do concerning their family and their future. And I will tell you, while I don't like it, I applaud the kind of integrity that they have to do what they're doing and the reasons they're going back home to Ohio. They've given us four of the best years of their life, the beginning years of their life together. And Lauren has been at home many nights by herself with their dog. And dog's pretty good size, lad, but still, it wasn't Blake, even though the dog's a lot less trouble than Blake. Thank you, Lord, I like that too. But she didn't sign up for this. She thought she was getting married, starting her life. And the reason I'm talking about Lauren more than Blake is because you know what Blake's done. You've seen him. You've seen him grow right in front of our eyes. And I have as well. And I thank God for watching that. But at the same time, I've seen a young lady mature faster than she wanted to. She was already much more mature than most everybody on my bus when she got here. If you only knew. It's not an easy life. And for you to consent to start your married life with your new husband and have him half of the time, speaks volumes to me about the character and the integrity of you as a young lady that loves the Lord. And I've told both of you that I love you, and I'm not kidding. I probably got too close to you. And if I did, tough. But I want these folks to help me thank you all for four of the best years of your life given to this ministry.